Today, we're going to conduct an eye exam. I'm going to shine this light in your eyes to check the condition of your eyesight. The eye does not see the light. Vision is therefore a relation with a something established within a relation with what is not a something. We are in the light in as much as we thing in nothingness. The light makes the thing appear by driving out the shadows. It empties space. It makes space arise specifically as a void, in so much as the movement of the hand that touches traverses the nothing of space. Touch resembles vision, nevertheless. Vision has over the touch the privilege of maintaining object in this void and receiving it always from this nothingness as from an origin. As in touch, nothingness is manifested to the free movement of palpitation. Thus, for vision and for touch, being comes as though from nothingness, and in this precisely resides their traditional philosophical prestige. This coming forth from void is thus their coming forth from their origin, this openness of experience, or this experience of openness explains the privilege of objectivity and its claim to coincide with the very being of existence. But is not this spatial void a something? The form of all experience, the object of geometry, something seen in its turn. In fact, it is. necessary to make a stroke in order to see a line, whatever be the significance of the passage to the limit. The notions of intuitive geometry will impose themselves upon us from things seen. The line is the limit of a thing, the plane, the surface of an object. It is on the basis of a something that geometrical notions impose themselves. They are experimental notions, not because they would be contrary to reason, but because they become objects of view only on the basis of things they are. Limits of things, but illuminated space involves the attenuation of these limits unto nothingness, their vanishing. Considered in itself, illuminated space, emptied by light of the obscurity that filled it, is nothing. To be sure, this void is not equivalent to absolute nothingness. To traverse it is not equivalent to transcending. But if empty space differs from nothingness, and if the distance it opens does not justify a claim transcendence in the movement that traverses it, yet its plenitude nowise returns it to the status of an object. This plenitude is of another order. If the void that light produces in the space from which it drives out darkness is not equivalent to nothingness, even in the absence of any particular object, there is this void itself. It does not exist by virtue of a play on words. The negation of every qualifiable thing allows the impersonal "there is" to arise again, returning intact behind. Every negation, whatever be the degree of negation, silence of infinite spaces is terrifying. The invasion of this "there is" does not correspond to any representation we have described elsewhere. Its Face to face, into vision, it catches sight of the space across which things are transported toward one another. Space, instead of transporting beyond, simply ensures the condition for the lateral signification of things within the same. To see hence is always to see on the horizon. The vision that apprehends on the horizon does not encounter a being out of what is, beyond all being. Vision is a forgetting of there is because of the essential satisfaction, the agreeableness of sensibility.